In this video, we're going to use the order of operations in order to simplify this expression that has several different types of parentheses in it. We must remember that order of operations is PEMDAS, or please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, which means we need to start with parentheses. And as we start inside the parentheses, we see these squiggly brackets. And inside those parentheses, we start over again and look for the new set of parentheses, the square brackets. And inside of those parentheses, you'll notice there's another set of parentheses, the curved brackets. All these types of parentheses are just written different, so it's easy to tell which one goes with which. There's nothing special about it. We need to start at the innermost parentheses. And inside that innermost parentheses, we need to do exponents first, starting over with order of operations. So the only thing I'm going to do in this step is the 3 squared. So we now have 2 times 8 squared minus 7 times 32 minus 4 times 3 squared is 9, plus 1 square parentheses times negative 1 squiggly parentheses. We still are not done with that innermost parentheses, so let's do that next, giving us 2 times 8 squared minus 7 times 32 minus 4 times 9 plus 1 is 10 times negative 1, and close the squiggly parentheses. And we finally have that parentheses simplified down to a simple number. So now we can start looking outward at the next set of parentheses, which is these square ones. Order of operations says we want to multiply before we do the subtraction. So that's what we're going to do next, is we're going to multiply the negative 4 times the 10. Notice as we're doing this, I'm doing one thing at a time and copying everything else exactly like it is. 2 times 8 squared minus 7 times 32 minus 4 times 10 is 40, times negative 1, close the squiggly. We still aren't done inside those parentheses, so we'll keep working those out. 2 times 8 squared minus 7 times 32 minus 40 is negative 8, times negative 1, and close the squiggly. And finally, we've got that parentheses done, so now we're ready to look at this greater parentheses and work out what's happening in there. Order of operations says we're going to do the exponents first, so let's do that exponent. We've got 2 times 8 squared is 64, minus 7 times negative 8, times negative 1. Next order of operations inside that squiggly parentheses wants us to multiply from left to right. Only going to multiply one thing at a time, the negative 7 times the negative 8, giving us 2 times 64. Negative times a negative is positive 56, times negative 1. And I'm running out of space on here, so I'm going to scroll up a bit, so we have some space to continue to work. Still multiplying from left to right inside those squiggly parentheses, so we have 2 times 64. 56 times negative 1 is negative 56. And finally, we're ready to finish up those squiggly parentheses. 64 minus 56 is 8. We now have 2 times 8. And we can finally finish this off by multiplying to get our final answer of 16. Depending on the problem, we can have several parentheses start to stack up on us. It's important as we do, we remember the order of operations tell us to start at the innermost parentheses, use order of operations inside that innermost parentheses, and then we'll work our way out, continuing to use order of operations inside each set of parentheses, until we achieve our final solution.